Morning students, today we are going to be discuss the second chapter of history, historiography. Okay, historiography, Indian tradition. In last standard we have studied about the history, standard we are going to be study the writing of the history and applied history, the different method adopted of writing the history. Okay, so in last chapter we have studied about the historiography, Western tradition. Okay, the first we are going to understand what is the historiography. Historiography means critical writing of narrative history. जो नरेट की जा रही हिस्ट्री को उसको क्रिटिकली राइट करना, उसको रिटर्न फॉर्म में लाना, उसको हम कहेंगे हिस्टोरियोग्राफी. ओके, वी लर्न अबाउट द वेस्टर्न ट्रेडिशन ऑफ हिस्टोरियोग्राफी इन द लास्ट लेसन. रिनोन नेम ऑफ द हिस्टोरियोग्राफी इन वेस्टर्न, वी हैव लर्न अबाउट देम, कार्ल मार्क्स, देन René Descartes, Leopold von Ranke, Voltaire are one of the renowned scholar and the historian who gave the scientific approach to the history in Western countries. Okay, now we'll start the study of the Indian historiography. The Indian historiography is divided into the era wise. Ancient historiography or ancient period, the historiography of ancient period, then medieval historiography, then modern period of time where the historiography is written, again the modern period divided into the post independence era and pre independence era. In that way the historiography is given in Indian. Okay, now first we'll talk about the ancient historiography. Ancient historiography, generally the ancient memories of ancestor are present in the form of the memories. Memories, that is a mythological lore. ओके, ट्रेडिशनल जो मैथोलॉजिकल लोर से स्टोरी है जो ओरली हम लोग कहते थे उसके फॉर्म में हमको एंशियंट हिस्टोरियोग्राफी की इंफॉर्मेशन मिलती है. सेकंड है आर्ट ऑफ राइटिंग. जनरली हम लोगों को व्हेन वी हैव स्टार्टेड द राइटिंग ऑफ आर्ट, दैट इज अर्ली मिलेनियम बीसी. ओके, दैट टाइम द इंस्क्रिप्शन दैट वी हैव फाउंड द हरप्पन सील्स गेव द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस योर राइटिंग वर्क. ओके, बट इट्स हरप्पन सील इज नॉट सक्सेसफुली डिसिफर्ड, मीन्स उसको भी सक्सेसफुली हमने डिकोडिंग किया है, वी हैव नॉट कम्प्लीटली अंडरस्टूड द रिटन वर्क ऑफ दिस हरप्पन कॉइन. ओके, नेक्स्ट है द अर्लियर नोन डॉक्यूमेंट हिस्टोरिकल नेचर विच फाउंड इन द थर्ड सेंचुरी बीसी, दैट इज अशोक मौर्यास टाइम. अशोक मौर्य के टाइम में जो हमको रिटन वर्क जो हम फुल्ली डिसिफर कर पाए हैं वो हमको देखने को मिला है, that which is edicted and inscribed on the pillars, right? The whatever the message Ashoka, Emperor Ashoka want to give the their people, okay? He write it over a rock or over a pillars, okay, which were given to the their people. So in that way, the written work of history we can get it in the form of the pillars, okay? From the first centuries, inscription began to occur in coins, metal images and the sculptures. के बाद हमको मिले हैं inscription that is the form of coins, metal or images के form में, copper plates के form में. Okay, the inscription began to be occur. Then they began to depict the king's dynasty, genealogies, जो भी हमको information मिली है उसमें क्या depict किया जाता था, जनरली उनके dynasty के बारे में, kings के बारे में, उनकी genealogies के बारे में, उसके अलावा किंगडम्स के बारे में, हाउ दे डू द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द किंगडम्स, ऑल दिस इंफॉर्मेशन, सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, क्लाइमेट, दिस आर गिवन थ्रू दिस स्कल्पचर, द मॉन्यूमेंट्स, टू दिस पॉइंट. ओके, द वन ऑफ द कॉपर प्लेट विच आर फाउंड इन द गोरखपुर उत्तर प्रदेश एट द सहपुरा गौरा, दैट इज अ कॉपर प्लेट विच वॉज द मौर्यन प्लेट. मौर्यन पे ही कॉपर प्लेट हमको मिली है आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे में, दैट इज इन गोरखपुर, हु हैज सिंबल ऑफ द नोन ट्री ऑन रेलिंग माउंटेन, सिंबल्स को देखने को मिले हैं विच एनकोडेड और विच इज रेड एज इंडिकेटिव ऑफ द ग्रेनरी. क्या इंडिकेट कर रहे हैं? ग्रेनरी के इंस्क्रिप्शन ही इंडिकेट कर रहे हैं. ओके, दिस अबाउट द सोहागुरा कॉपर प्लेट. नाउ नेक्स्ट है एंशियंट इंडियन लिटरेचर इंक्लूड एपिक्स, दूसरे उसके अलावा है एंशियंट पीरियड एपिक्स लाइक रामायण, महाभारत. ओके, दिस एपिक्स were found as a source of the history. Second, historical document. Okay, historical document in the form of Vedas. Now, religious text which includes your, what kind of religious text? Buddhist, Jains, this religious text again become the source of the history of writing. travelogue written by the travelers who travel from one place to another and write the all the information, detailed information where they have traveled, right? In the form of travelogue. These are again some of the important sources for the writing of the history. Then the most important written biographies of the kings and dynasty history mark an important step in the Indian historiography. That is again Harshacharita, written by the 7th century CE by the king Harsha. Okay, it portrays the realistic picture of social, economic, political, religious and cultural life. Uske alawa Harsha, King Harsha ki jo biography hai, written by the Pandavatta. In the form of Harshacharita, we can get the information about during the period of King Harsha, how they have did the administration, political, religious, cultural life. Okay, this is again example of your ancient period historiography. Okay, Kalhana, again the most important twin books that we have got written by the Kalhana. He wrote about a 12th century CE book Raj Tarangini on the book of history Kashmir. Kashmir ki history ke bare mein hi Raj Tarangini books hai. His style of writing resembles the concept and modern historiography. Book has written after the critically examining the various sources of like inscription, coins, remains of ancient manuscript, dynasty records and local tragedies. In sabhi ko critically examine karne ke baad Kalhana himself has written this all these books of Raj Tarangini, which is based on the history of the Kashmir. उसके बाद हम है हमारे पास the next books or the next sorry next historiography is the medieval period. It's all about the ancient historiography. Okay, ancient period में हम लोगों के पास कौन-कौन से sources थे history के लिखने के लिए? What are the epics we have used? What are the epics and historical documents, religious texts, the text, travelogue, that are again the data provided for the writing the historiography. The most renowned name of Kalhana who has given the history of the Kashmir under the book of Raj Tarangini. Then again the name, next year Harshacharita given by Banapatta. These are the important sources of the ancient historiography. Now we move towards the medieval historiography. Medieval historiography, the era start from the 12th century. Okay, 12th century जो era start होता है इसको हम कहते हैं medieval period. Okay, and generally this medieval period are mostly dominated by the Mughal or Muslim historians, Muslim period. Okay, so that's why we observe the historiography written in the medieval period mostly by the Muslim historian. The renowned name of the Muslim historian like Ziauddin Barani, Babur, Abul Fazl. Okay, so let's look at this history. Now first, the Ziauddin Barani, who had important place for writing the history in the medieval period, that is his work in Tariq-e-Firozshahi, book written by him, stated the purpose of historiography. According to the Ziauddin Barani, duties writing of history is duty is not limited only the recording the ruler's valor or policies of welfare, but we should also put down the ruler's falling and incorrect policy. Okay, Barani further says that the historian should also take the consideration of impact of teaching of the wise and the learned and the saints and the cultural life people. Thus Barani expanded the scope of historiography. In that way Barani gave its critical writing of the history. Okay, now for the historian in the Mughal court, praising the emperor and exhibition of loyalty becomes more important. Mughal period mein sabse important place ko mili thi emperor ko praise karna, uske through loyalty express karna, to isko sabse important place mili. Aur isi ne change kiya again the new custom of writing the history, that is adding the beautiful quotes and the pictures in the text about the kings. Okay, these are one of the custom made by the historians of writing the historiography. Babur again the founder of the Mughal empire, who written his autobiography, that is your Tuzuk-e-Babri, jisme unhone description diya hai the battle fought by the Babur. Okay, that way he gave the again source of the history. Then again Abul Fazl had written the Akbarnama. Okay, in the books of Akbarnama he critically give the viewpoint of historiography. His method of collecting the authentic historical documents and thus putting इज लुक्ड अपॉन द डिवाइड बायस एंड हेंस रियलिस्टिक। अबुल फज्ल की अकबर नामा बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है, इसमें क्रिटिकल राइटिंग ऑफ हिस्ट्री है, इसने बहुत ज्यादा स्कोप दिया है आपके हिस्टोरियोग्राफी। द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, नाउ फर्स्ट विल गो टू डू यू नो अल बैरूनी रोल इन अरेबिक अबाउट इंडियन नॉलेज एंड सोशल लाइफ। द फॉलोइंग पीरियड ऑफ मेनी बुक्स हैज बीन रिटन बाय अमंग द फ्यू हिस्टोरियंस, बुक बाय रिटन बाय द मुस्लिम हिस्टोरियन हसन निजामी वाज गिवन द बुक्स ताजुल मासी। ओके, आमिर तिमूरी हु गिव हिज राइटिंग ऑफ हिस्ट्री इन द बुक ऑफ तुजुके तिमूर। ओके, नेक्स्ट यहिया बिन अहमद सिरहिंदी हु गिव द राइटिंग ऑफ हिज बुक अंडर द तारीख मुबारक शाही। Then Tabaqat Nasiri gave his written work under the books of the Minhaj Siraj. These were some of the books written by the Muslim historian during the medieval period. Okay. Now Bakhar again the most important type of historical document written during the period of the history. Okay. Now, what is the Bakhar? Generally, it contains the eulogies of heroes and the stories of historical events, battles, lives of the great men. It contains constant information of the eulogies, the great heroes hai unki written form of history likhi aati hai, usko hum kehte hain eulogies. Okay. Now, types of Bakhar generally state administration by kings, history of sect, description of events based on mythology. Regarding the grievances, dynastic history, biographies of king, these are the some of the types of Bakhar, that is the writing the story, history. Okay, the Bakhars can be divided into the various types. Okay, that is here, these are the some of the types of Bakhar. Okay, now features of Muslim historiography. The Muslim historian in medieval India were influenced by Arabic and Persian historiography. Arabic or Persian historiography से बहुत influence होते थे इनकी writing work. Again they show the loyalty and eloquence of praising the emperor reflected in their historiography. Again इनकी historiography क्या reflect करते हैं? They have loyalty and have the praising the their kings and emperor. Then the practice of adding suitable poetic quotes, again one of the most important feature of the Muslim historiography. And we are also adding the beautiful pictures in the writing of historiography. Okay, now we come to the information, chronicle information of the Bakhar. Information chronicle in Bakhar, information about the first ruler of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, then was given by the Sabhasad Bakhar, written by Krishna Ji Anand Sabhasad. Then description of battle of Panipat written by the Bahu Saibanchi Bakhar. Then next say Holkaranchi Kaifian, this again gave the information about the Holkar and their contribution in Maratha rule. Then Panipatchi Bakhar, who gave the information about the description of the battle of Panipat. Okay, these are all about the historiography in medieval period. This was a revision related to medieval historiography. How we have seen the medieval historiography mostly the written by the Muslim historian. The renowned name in the Muslim historian has Ziauddin Barani, Babur, Abul Fazl, some of the books which have been written by the Muslim historian. Okay, then again what the feature of this Muslim historiography, most important feature, the adding the poetic device, beautiful pictures, then you're praising the emperor, showing the loyalty, exhibiting the loyalty towards the emperor. This was the most important feature of the medieval historiography. Okay, now come toward the historiography modern period. Okay, we'll start with the next modern period. Divided into the post-independence era and pre-independence era. Okay, so first we'll go through the historiography in the modern period. Okay, now modern historiography in modern period, archaeological excavation started in the 20th century under the British rule. Many British officers wrote about the Indian history. Okay, their writing showed their great influences of the colonial policies of the British, and their writings display an absence of objective perspective and prejudices about the various aspects of the Indian culture. Generally, the modern period of Indian historiography likhi gayi hai. It mostly attempted by the British historians. Okay. अब उनके हिस्टोरियोग्राफी से हमको क्या मालूम पड़ता है कि दे हैव द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ राइटिंग द पॉलिसीज ऑफ दिस ब्रिटिश. ठीक है, उनका जनरली जो इन्फ्लुएंस था किसके ऊपर था, हाउ द ब्रिटिश रूल हैड ओवर द इंडियन. सेकंड, दे हैव नो ऑब्जेक्टिव, मींस देयर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज जस्ट टू अपसेट शो द हाउ वाज द इंडियन. Okay, that means there are absence of objective of writing the historiography. Then the perspective are very different. Okay, they have the conceptual framework about the British rule, British policies. Then they have prejudices about the Indians. So that's why the historiography written by the most of the this West British historian. Okay. Now let's come to the some of the British officers who wrote the historiography. Sir Alexander Cunningham, okay, whose work have given in the form of first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India. Number of ancient sites were excavated during the period of under the work of Sir Alexander Cunningham. Sites mentioned in the British text were selected for the excavation and research. Okay, next, name for Sir John Marshall, who again worked for the Harappan civilization, was discovered. Then it proved that Indian civilization dated back to the 3rd millennium BC. The next, James Mill, who gave his work under the book The History of British India. The first book written in Indian history by the British historian, that was by James Mill. He gave his books in 3 volumes, which is published in 1817. It lacked the again objectivity. Okay. Then next, Mount Stuart Elphinstone. Again, he written the books History of India, Governor of Bombay, now Mumbai, published 1841. Okay, he write down his books History of India, which is published in 1841. Next is British officer who write the history about Indian, that is a Grand Duff. Okay, the history of Marathas is published in 3 volumes, again show the inclination towards the condemning Indian culture, right, and the history. Colonel Todd, who gave the books Todd's Annals of Rajasthan, he wrote the about the Rajasthan. Then it show he had condemning attitude towards the Indians. William Wilson Hunter, again brief history, written the books of A Brief History of India. He wrote 2 volumes on Indian history, who shows the somewhat impartial treatment of the history. Okay, let us know about the Sir Alexander Cunningham. Sir Alexander Cunningham was the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. He developed an interest in history of and archaeology, being company of his contemporary James Prinsep. He carried but excavation at Sarnath and wrote a book on it. He wrote on sculptures in temples of Kashmir, numismatic temple stupas, and geography. He studied and conducted research on relics found in both Bodh Gaya. He had laid the foundation of the different disciplines required for study of archaeology. This is the information about the Sir Alexander Cunningham. Okay, now we'll go to the Sir John Marshall. Again, who was the Director of Archaeology of India from 1902-1931 during his tenure. Excavation of Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Takshila, Sachi were carried out. He modernized the approach of cataloging and conservation of ancient monuments. He published information on inscriptions discovered at various sites. His most important work is the discovery of Indus Valley Civilization. Next, information given about the James Mill. Again, he was the Scottish philosopher, historian, and economist. Started writing the history of British India in 1806 and completed it in 1870. It was published in 3 volumes. His book was the first full historical treatment of British conquest in India. Mill harshly criticized the British administration of India during his 17 years of service with the India House. He had completely reformed the system of the government in the colony. Mountstuart Elphinstone, again he was the governor of Bombay from 1819 to 1827. He was a British official who did much to promote the popular education and local administration. As envoy, he was appointed the court of Peshwa II Bhosle of Nagpur, and in the court of Gwalior, he knew the Greek, Marathi, Roman and Persian languages. The wealthy natives of Bombay founded a college and institute to honor him for his work. James Grandeur, he was appointed to the important office of resident of Satara state, managed affairs of the state. While in Satara, he collected the historical texts, bakhas, sanads, manuscripts, etc. And he collected letters of Aurangzeb, Shivaji's letters to Jankoji. During the period between 1818 to 1822, he wrote a book of history of Marathas in 3 volumes. Okay, so we'll go through the first modern day writer of history, British officer. Generally, जो history लिखी गई किसकी लिखी आपकी British officer. The most important name Alexander Cunningham. Archaeological survey के governor थे ये. Next, James Mill, then Grandeur, okay. Then next your Mountstuart Elphinstone, next your Colonel Todd, William Hunter. Okay, these are some of the officers who has written this history. Okay. Now we move towards the next nationalist historiography. Okay. Okay, before going to national historiography, let us understand the Indian historiography, where this ideological framework, okay, various ideological framework have been developed for writing the Indian historiography. Okay, that's first, we'll go through these various aspect. Indian historiography, the various conceptual framework has been developed. Okay, we'll go through the ideological framework that is developed. The very first, the colonial historiography. The name itself is the colonial historiography, which is written historiography about the colonies. Okay, it was mainly written by British and the Christian missionaries. This historiography, their writing reflects their view that Indian culture has negligible importance, ridiculated Indian culture has perpetually backward and undeveloped. Okay, so in that way, colonial historiography gave the does not give any importance to the Indians. Next, Orientalist historiography, many European scholars felt curious about the civilization of the countries of East. And some of the scholars who acquired respect for him, the scholar returned known as the Orientalist. Orientalist means who have returned this, the civilization of the country. Okay, Orientalist. Many European historians who had written curiously about the Indian East, about the countries of East, the comparative study of Sanskrit and some of the European languages were conducted by the Orientalists. Their studies resulted in perception that an Indian languages could be the mother of all Indo-European languages. Okay, the like in 1784, Sir William Johns, one of the Orientalist historians. Sir William Jones. Okay. okay, who was again orientalist historian who has curiosity about writing of history of the East, okay. Then Sir William Jones, who had given founded the Ashik Society in Kolkata 1784, he channelized the research in ancient Indian literature and history. The next name is your Friedrich Max Müller, again. Then Egbert, okay, this was some of the name of Orientalist historians. Now Friedrich Max Müller, who deeply is deep interested in Sanskrit language and literature, he translated the German Hitopadesh into the German. He published the volumes of the sacred books of Rig Veda in 6 volumes. Next, Edward Said, he had brought the imperialistic interest of the Orientalist historians into life. Next, nationalist historiography. Orientalist historiography who have the negative perspective about the Indians. Orientalist historiography who want to write the about curiosity about the writing of the East and some of the Orientalist historians. Sir William Jones, Friedrich Max Müller and Edward. Now we'll come to the nationalist historiography. What is the nationalist historiography? English educated Indian historian, generally English person who had educated in, Indian historian, felt the need to restore the pride of the glory of ancient Indian culture. Their writings are known as nationalistic historiography. इन्हीं के writing को बोला गया है nationalistic historiography. Nationalistic writings in Maharashtra were inspired by Vishnu Shastri Chitrunkar. Indian person who had education in English had curiosity and want to be need to restore the pride of Indian, and the person and such a person who had written this history is known as nationalistic historiography. The most important name in national historiography was the Vishnu Shastri Chitrunkar, who criticized the prejudice about history of writing ancient India by the British officer. National historian tried to seek the golden era of Indian history. They are at a time also blamed ignoring the critical analysis of the historical truth. Next name, Mahadev Govind Ranade, Ramakrishna Gopal Bhandarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, Rajendra Lal Mishra, Ramesh Chandra Majumdar, Kashi Prasad Jaiswal, Radha Kumud Mukherjee, Bhagwan Lal Inderji, Vasudev Vishnu Mirashi, Ananda Sadashiv Aldekar. These are some of the name, renowned name of this scholar who had written the nationalist historiography. The Justice Mahadev Govind Ranade, who had written the book The Rise of Maratha Power. Okay. According to him, it was not like a suddenly erupted forest fire, but the ground for it has been developed so of many of time, and religious level was getting ready over a prolonged period. ठीक है, ये कोई एक दो दिन में नहीं हुआ है जो राइज ऑफ मराठा है. इट वॉज बैकग्राउंड प्रिपेयर प्रोलॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, रजवाड़े विच इज वेल नोन फॉर राइटिंग इन मराठी ऑन वेरी सब्जेक्ट लाइक हिस्ट्री, लिंग्विस्टिक, इडियोमोलॉजी. इडियोमोलॉजी मीन साइंस ऑफ राइटिंग द ओरिजिनल एंड वर्ड, सो ये थे इडियोमोलॉजी. ओके, ही वॉज फ्रॉम फॉर ओपिनियन दैट वी शुड राइट अवर ओन हिस्ट्री. Most of the Indian historians, like B.K. Rajwade, जो ये believe करते थे कि we should write our own history. Nobody has a perspective of writing the Indian historiography, right? They have their own conceptual work, they have their own point of view of writing the history. That's why as a Indian, we should write our own history. Okay, he compiled again and edited 22 volumes of the Marathacharya Itihasachi Sadhane. He wrote every scholarly preface to each 22 volumes. He stated history is the all inclusive image. इनके मुताबिक इन history क्या सभी images को include करना चाहिए, वो societies हो, और हमें वो exclude नहीं करना चाहिए जो कि political image हो, conspiracy हो, wars हो, seizing power हो. Okay, all inclusive image of post society we should include, but it does not include the stories about the political image, seizing the power, then conspiracies. Okay, then again insisted upon writing of the authentic documentary, so we should use the authentic document for the writing the history. That means historiography again helped the triggering the independence movement of the Indian people against the British. In this aspect, the book The Indian War of the Independence 1857, given by the Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, again have the great importance, which analyze and trigger the movement of independence during the British period. Okay, is about the nationalist historiography. Okay, now come to the historiography in post independence era. Generally, after the attaining getting the independence. Now, along with the writing of dynastic history, the cultural, social, economic history were also being written. Scholars of the post-independence era feel the writing of various history about the various community. Now, generally, trend ke how can start after the national historiography, after attaining the independence. Now, trend is start about writing about the communities. Communities ke baare mein history ka trend ban chuka tha. Ye custom develop ho raha tha in post-independence era. Okay. में सबसे मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट हिस्टोरियोग्राफी जो कि थी आइडियोलॉजिकल स्कूल में हमने बांटी है. सबसे पहली वो मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्टोरी है, स्कूल ऑफ थॉट, सब अल्टरनेट हिस्ट्री. ठीक है, देन नेक्स्ट आपकी फेमिनिस्ट हिस्ट्री. ओके, तो मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्ट्री अगेन गिवन बाय द कार्ल मार्क्स, उसका इफेक्ट इंडियंस पे क्या था, इसमें हम वो स्टडी करने वाले हैं. द मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्ट्री द कंसर्न फॉर द मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन मोड्स एंड द इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशन. मार्क्स हिस्ट्री में किसको हाईलाइट किया गया था, मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड इंडस्ट्री रिलेशन, दोनों के रिलेशन को हाईलाइट किया गया था भाई मार्क्स हिस्ट्री में. ओके, नाउ इसका सिग्निफिकेंस क्या था भाई, यही बेसिक थीम है इसकी आपकी इस मार्क्स हिस्टोरी का. सोशल इवेंट जनरली जज किए गए थे मार्क्स हिस्ट्री में. मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्टोरियंस इन इंडिया स्टडी द ट्रांजिशन विद इन द कास्ट सिस्टम. अमंग द नोटेबल इंडियन हिस्टोरियन हु अडॉप्टेड द मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्टोरियोलॉजिकल आइडियोलॉजिकल, सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट नेम है उसमें दामोदर, धर्मानंद कोसंबी, कॉम्रेड श्रीपाद अमृत दांगे, राम शरण शर्मा, कॉम्रेड शरद पाटिल, हु हैड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड नोटेबली इन द राइटिंग ऑफ मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्ट्री. ओके, नाउ अगेन इज बेस्ड ऑन द primitive communism slavery book written by the Marxist historiography comrade Dange. ठीक है, comrade Dange जिन्होंने लिखी है primitive communism to slavery. okay, next subaltern history. now what is subaltern history? subaltern history is history about the your classes, bottomist history. ठीक है, history writing का trend था, हम अभी तक ऊपर की क्लास लिखते आ रहे थे. नाउ द ट्रेंड हैज स्टार्टेड टू राइटिंग द हिस्ट्री अबाउट द बॉटमस पीपल, बॉटमस सोसाइटी. ओके, द सीड्स ऑफ सबाल्टर्न हिस्ट्री वेर फाउंड इन द मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्टोरियोग्राफी. द रोल ऑफ इटालियन हिस्टोरियन एंटोनी ग्रोम्स्की, ठीक है, इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डेवलपिंग द आइडिया दैट हिस्ट्री शुड बी रिटन स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम बॉटमस रैंक्स ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ द सोसाइटी. रंजीत गुहा, इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस प्लेड अ मेजर रोल इन एस्टैब्लिशिंग द सबाल्टर्न हिस्ट्री इन इंडिया. That again we may point out much before the onset of subaltern ideology, similar thoughts were expressed by Mahatma Gandhi. See के हमको scene देखने को मिलते हैं by Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar according to the Mahatma Jyotirao Phule. So Mahatma Jyotirao Phule who had again unfolded the history of the Shudra Ati Shudra, right? Then communities in his book Gulam Giri. He grew the attention of exploitation of the men and women of the Shudras, then he and Ati Shudras. Next, the renowned name of the writing in the history about the Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, who again played a very important role, who belonging to the Dalit caste, and he gave the important role, which was the Dalit was not considerable or acknowledged. In the colonial national historiography, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar focusing on this fact that consistently wrote about the two books, who were the Shudras and the Untouchables. Okay, these are the two main books written by the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, again was the example of the subaltern history. Okay, now next, feminist history. Feminist history, again, what is the feminist history? Significant period of time ke baad. Now, Indian history mein women ka role badhne laga tha. Women have started to achieve the role in the Indian history. Okay, now the it was important to study the feminist historians to compile the historical writing of women. अभी क्यों हमको जरूरी है पढ़ना, क्योंकि हमको इम्पोर्टेंस, वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंट स्टडी ऑफ द वुमेन इन फेमिनिस्ट हिस्टोरियंस. ओके, नाउ फेमिनिस्ट हिस्टोरियन अमंग द वुमेन ऑथर्स राइटिंग अबाउट द वुमेन इन 19th सेंचुरी दैट इज तारावाई शिंदे, वन ऑफ द फोर मोस्ट हिस्टोरियंस हू हैड गिवन द रिटर्न हर इन फेमिनिस्ट हिस्ट्री. देन शी हैज अटैकिंग the male-dominated society, work written by Tarabai Shinde attacking the male-dominated society caste system in his book Stree Purush Tulana, which is published in 1882. Is acknowledged as the first feminist book in India. 1888, the book written by Pandita Ramabai Ranade, who published the entitled The High Caste Hindu Woman. Okay, feminist literature of the post-independence era concentrated on the issues, generally employment of women, treatment of women, their right of political equality. इन सभी इश्यू पर generally feminist history का work हुआ करता था. Recently जो feminist historian है literature work जो देख हमें वो है मीरा गोस्वामी book जो कि Crossing Threshold. ये books में उन्होंने मीरा गोस्वामी हो गया तो feminist history. Feminist essay on social history is of the importance. It is contains the essay of life stories of women like Pandita Ramabai and Dr. Rukmabai, the first practicing lady of doctor in India. A lot of literature is available unfolding the viewpoint of Dalit women in Maharashtra. Say Dr. Sharmila Rege, who worked noteworthy in context of the Dalit women in her book Writing Caste, Writing Gender. ठीक है, उसके अलावा है दलित वुमेन टेस्टिमनीज इंक्लूडेड हर एसे ऑटोबायोग्राफी और दलित वुमेन आल्सो इंक्लूडेड इन हर बुक्स राइटिंग कास्ट एंड राइटिंग जेंडर. उसके अलावा देयर हैव बीन अ नंबर ऑफ इंडियन हिस्टोरियन जिन्होंने बहुत सारे बुक्स लिखे हैं, जैसे कि आपके सर जादुनाथ सरकार है, सुरेंद्र नाथ सेन है, रिया सरकार, जी एस ए सरदेसाई एंड त्र्यंबक शंकर शेजवाड़कर. इन सभी मोस्ट ऑफ द नोटवर्दी हिस्टोरियन से जिन्होंने इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस को में हिस्टोरियन दी हिस्ट्री दी है. ओके, रिसेंट टाइम हिस्टोरियन है यशवंत दिनाकर फड़के रामचंद्र गुहा. ओके, हु कंट्रीब्यूट एक्सटेंसिवली इन मॉडर्न हिस्टोरियोग्राफी. दस इट हैज एविडेंट दैट इंडियन हिस्टोरियोग्राफी हैज बीन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड ग्रेटली बाय द सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल मूवमेंट. Okay, this was the influence of this movement again written who has gave the on historiography. In sabhi ka influence humko dekhne ko milta, we have seen this influence over the written work of the historiography. Okay, this is all about the second chapter, Indian tradition of writing the historiography. Then we have seen the ancient period dekha humne, medieval period dekha, ancient period library jo bhi hum logo ke paas archaeological survey pe found hue that will become the source of the writing of the history of ancient period. Then medieval period, in medieval period we have seen the Muslim historians who have give this written work and who become the history of the medieval period, okay, historiography of medieval period. Then modern period, in modern period we have divided pre-independence and post-independence era. Pre-independence era, British officers have gave this written work. Okay, pre-independent, post-independent, generally communities की basis से लिखी जा रही थी. मार्क्स हिस्ट्री है, सबाल्टर्न हिस्ट्री, फेमिनिस्ट हिस्ट्री, दिस आर द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट पॉइंट दैट वी हैव सीन इन दिस चैप्टर. ओके, हियर वी एंड द चैप्टर. सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड. थैंक यू.